Thanks, Jeff. Hello, this is Annabelle from Colonial Times News. Breaking news. A time machine has landed on the Space Needle. Now, we have some interviews from people in the past who played great roles in the Revolutionary War. The first person we get to speak to today is a colonial hero we all like to call Molly Pitcher. So Molly, what role did you play in the war?
I gave water to the soldiers, and when my husband was too weak to fight, I manned a cannon.
Wow, Molly, that's really impressive. Why do they call you Molly Pitcher?
They call me this because I brought pitchers of water to thirsty soldiers in the war.
Thank you, Molly, for your time. Your work for America was extremely impressive.
Thank you, I try. And remember, there are many other women who helped in this war, but I'm one of the famous ones.
Now, we have an interview of notorious King George, who was hated by most of the colonists. So, how does it feel to be hated by patriots around America?
I think hate to be a very strong word. But, next question.
What was your part in the Revolutionary War?
I'm the king. I'm boss.
Okay, so what exactly did you do?
I ignored their wishes and rights. I put the tax on tea and many other taxes. I made them pay unfairly, of course. I am a boss.
Alright, so the Americans won?
Yes, but I'm still a boss.
Thank you for your time. You've been very unhelpful to America.
You're welcome, but I hate you. Oh yeah, I jump in front of a train. Oh yeah,
you know I'd do anything. So, Paul, what role did you play in the Revolutionary War?
When the Patriot spies in Boston found out that Thomas Gage was planning to steal an American supply of weapons, they informed us, the Patriots, and then we were on the lookout. As they advanced across our land, one lantern would shine. If they rode across Charles River, two lanterns would shine. I saw two lanterns and I set off on horseback with my good friend William Dawes on two different routes to sound alarm.
Thank you, Paul.
As they say in the future, peace out, home dog.
She stopped me in the doorway. She kissed.
Now, we have an interview with Captain John Parker.
Hey, how you doing?
Good. So what role did you play in the Revolutionary War?
Well, Annie, I was the captain of the Minutemen. I told all my troops, or I guess as you would say, in the future, my home bras, that they couldn't fire unless fired upon, but the British over here fired a shot.
We did not. No one knows who fired that shot. It could have very well been you.
No, it was you.
Was not.
Was too.
Okay, guys, break it up. We don't know who it was. John, continue on.
Thanks, babe. You can call me Johnny. As for him, you can call him BS. For British soldier and other things. Anyways, the battle ended in a matter of minutes, and no one won.
Did not. We outnumbered you.
Shut up, BS. Your full name.
Anyways, the bloody Americans, cough cough John, charged forward and we suffered a few deaths.
Yeah, more than a few.
Shut up.
You shut up.
No, you shut up.
Okay, that's all we have time for. Bye.
Bye, hot stuff. And by the way, did you see a beach ball about this big going that way or that way?
If you're one of us, then roll with us. Now, we get to speak to another inspirational woman named Abigail Adams. I was born in Massachusetts in 1744. I married John Adams, who was a colonial leader and signer of the Declaration of Independence. What did you think about women having rights? I thought that was unjust to take rights away from women. I told my husband that I wished he would remember the ladies, to be more generous to them than his ancestors, and to not put as much power in the hands of the husbands. Thank you, Abigail. Your words have been an inspiration to many women. Thank you. Now, we have an interview with the first known woman to fight in the war, named Deborah Sampson. So, Deborah, how did you pull this off?
I dressed up as a man, cutting my hair, wearing men's clothing, and I enlisted my name as Robert Shirtleff. If all the men believed that I was a boy and too young to shave, it all worked out very well until I got an injury and the doctor discovered that I was female. Then I got kicked out of the army, which was kind of a downer. Well, I guess I could show you what I wore in the war.
So as you see, this is my man outfit. I would talk in a deeper voice like, hey dude, what's up? And yeah, this is my soldier outfit.
Thanks, Deborah. Now, we have an interview with amazing war hero, George Washington.
Hey, Leslie. I was born in 1732, the day being February 22nd, to be exact, of course, after the Second Continental Congress meeting, they made me their commander-in-chief. I became president, and I served 2 terms, and then died of strep throat.
Thank you, George. That's it for tonight for Colonial Times News. Remember, if you see a time machine land in your backyard, it could be the British, so watch out! Hey guys, it's Kelsey. I was basically every character in this movie. Makeup's done by Kelsey. Songs are done by whoever the artists are, and yeah. And I would like to say that there was other battles in the war. such as the Battle of Bunker Hill and the Lortuga something. I can't pronounce vowels. But those were also very important, and there was a lot more important people in the army, or Continental Congress. But, yeah, so I would like to, like, thank my mom for getting me a MacBook for Christmas, because now I can do this. And I'd like to thank my English teacher, Paige, because she's awesome. And, yeah. So, remember that these characters aren't, like, exactly how they were in the war. Like, King George didn't have a deformed face. John Parker wasn't a creeper. And there was other stuff that, like, wasn't, like, Molly Pitcher. I don't know if she looks like that or not. So, but all the facts are true. And you can learn more about the Revolutionary War from reading some books at the library. Just go to your local library, check out some books on, like, John Adams, Abigail Adams. It's really interesting, and I have fun with this project. All right, thank you. Bye.